I would like to thank Cricut for sponsoring today's video.
Hello everyone and welcome back to Thrifted Living. My name is Kieran. In today's video, we are going to talk about what I think are the best projects that you can do as a beginner using a Cricut machine. I recently shared a video about my opinion if I think a Cricut is easy to use, and I will make sure to link that video above in case you'd like to check it out. The answer is yes, I think a Cricut is very easy to use. I think the Cricut brand has done a really great job in supporting people when learning how to use a Cricut. And in that video, I talk about all of the different reasons why I think it is easy to use a Cricut. So if you would like to learn more about that, I will make sure to link that video above. As I've said in previous videos, I am still new to using Cricut, so I definitely have a lot to learn still, but in my experience, these are the easiest projects that I've been able to do since I've started using my Cricut Joy machine. Maybe you just got your first Cricut machine and you're not exactly sure where to start or what a good project would be for you as a beginner. I would like to make some suggestions to you as to what I think are some great projects that you can start with as a beginner using Cricut. So the first projects that you could try as a beginner are labeling. And if you guys have been following my channel for a while, you know that I love to label. I love to label things in my craft room. I'm so excited to start labeling things in my classroom as well. For me, I think labeling items with your Cricut is a great way to start using your Cricut machine. You can do this by using the Cricut design space and figuring out exactly what size you need for the particular item that you are labeling. I have a craft room where I have an entire bookshelf. I'm actually looking at it right now. I have an entire bookshelf full of crafting supplies, and I actually have them in like plastic bins. I've been going through and creating labels for each of these bins, and it's a very simple project to do. You know what size you need for each label, and maybe you have a lot of them to do. Like in front of me, I have so many different bins of crafting products that I can label. It's very easy to go through, create the first label, and then you can duplicate that and then have the perfect size that you need for each additional label. I feel that creating labels is a great way to help you learn more about your particular machine, what it's able to do, what kind of products that you would like to use with it. I really love the idea of just being able to have everything sort of laid out in front of you. I've talked about in previous videos how I sort of struggle with that like artistic kind of, designing something with like different shapes and different images and things like that. For example, maybe I have a container that has paint in it and I can simply see, okay, this is paint. I need to create a label for that. So it's sort of taking that creative part out of it, and not in a bad way, in that for me, when I started using my Cricut, it was easier for me to sort of see like, okay, this is exactly what I'm making a label for, without it being too artistic, because I'm still trying to learn something. So in my opinion, creating labels is a good way to help you feel accomplished with what you're working on, being able to accomplish those first few projects using the machine without making it something where you have to design something elaborate. So that way, if it's a label for something in your home, you don't really have to worry about it being perfect. You can make mistakes on it. It's not like it's going to be a gift for somebody, that you feel like maybe you have a deadline, maybe you have a birthday party, or even just like a birth date that you need to get something done by. I think it sort of takes out that additional layer of stress maybe that might be there with trying to get a project done. So that would be my first suggestion. Creating labels is a great way to help you learn about your machine. I'm looking at the labels in front of me right now. It's also a really cool way to sort of see a vision come to reality in a very quick way. Creating labels would be my first suggestion for a great beginner project using your Cricut machine. The second project that I think would be great for a beginner is to create wall art. And I think this would be a great project for a beginner because chances are you have some items in your home that you can use to create this project where you don't have to go out and purchase anything. You can also use the design space to help you create exactly what you would like to make for that first piece of wall art. I also love the idea of creating wall art because you can go on Pinterest and get inspiration. You could say, okay, I like this image that I see right here on Pinterest. Maybe I want to add a couple other things to it and sort of get inspiration that way. You can also go onto the Cricut design space, and there are already so many pre-made images already ready for you. And I just love that about the design space, that, you know, you could say, okay, I want to create this image. This is the frame that I want to put it in. Or maybe you could say, I have this cutting board as an example. This is the size it is. This is an image that will work in that size. And the Cricut design space will tell you all of that. For me, when I was able to start creating wall art and different designs like that, it was the first time that I really felt like, wow, I made this, which is really cool. I definitely felt that way when I was labeling things. I started creating like holiday themed designs. I just felt so accomplished. I also love that with the wall art, you're able to really take your own personal style and look in the design space and see what they already have and within like 10-15 minutes, you're able to create something that you can immediately hang on the wall, and it's very simple to do. I think that would sort of be my advice from the beginning, is to not that you can't be creative, but take time and learn what is available to you within what Cricut already has. So I think that creating wall art would be a simple and easy way to really start feeling creative using the Cricut, but also allowing yourself to learn by using the design space and really leaning on those supports that Cricut has already in place for you as a new user of a Cricut machine. The third project that I think would be great for beginners is creating cards. I have absolutely loved creating cards using my Cricut Joy machine. I feel like I'll never purchase a card at the store ever again because of how simple it is to be able to create your own cards using the cardstock and then the inserts that Cricut has that goes with it. I think that the cards are a really great way to create a really high-end looking piece, but it's actually very, very simple to do. So for me, the cards are like a really great encouragement when I'm starting to learn something new. As I've said, and I feel like the main thing that I keep sharing throughout all of these different beginner projects is the design space. As a beginner, I would highly, highly recommend using the design space as much as you can because it takes so much of the guesswork out of it for you. Everything is already pre-made in the design space. You can definitely create your own projects and your own cards and your own wall art, but as a beginner, I would highly recommend really exploring that space first, really exploring the space and then just making stuff. One thing that I did was I recently made Christmas cards using the Cricut Joy machine, and it was so simple and so easy to do, and the results were amazing. Like, the cards looked so high end, and I literally just went to the design space, picked a style I liked, put the cards in the machine the way I needed to, and that's all I had to do. That would be my suggestion as another great project to do, is to make cards for people and make them for everything. Just make them and then hand them out, and then you can also get that feedback from people as well, which is really great when you're starting to work on a new material. So those would probably be my top three suggestions for best beginner projects: labeling items, creating wall art, and then also creating cards using the Cricut Joy machine. I love my Cricut Joy machine. I feel like it's everything I could possibly need in one machine. It's so intuitive, it's so easy to use. There is so much guidance online as well. There are so many people who are willing to help. Cricut really makes everything so easy and so intuitive, and I just absolutely love how all of these projects turn out. And it just makes me feel like the best crafter in the world, and I just love that. I just feel so accomplished when I use my Cricut products, and it just really takes my crafting to another level, and I just love that about the Cricut products. And that's it for today's Cricut video. I'd like to again thank Cricut for sponsoring today's video. I hope that you enjoyed hearing my thoughts on another top searched question. In the comments below, let me know what you think some great beginner projects are for Cricut as well. I definitely would love to be able to learn about some new projects, and I am definitely still a beginner myself, so I would love your suggestions in the comments below. Please check out my blog at thriftedlivingblog.com. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at thriftedliving, and if you don't have an Instagram but would like to stay up to date with what I'm doing, you can follow me on Facebook at thriftedliving page. Please like, subscribe, and share. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!